Hey, what's up, YouTube? I know it's been a while since I posted a video, but let's wrap. I don't have the numbers with me, but I can give you a rough estimate of what my breakdown was this week. Me being Lisa Burks with Thomas Keller. And tell you a little bit of my experience so far. But before we get to all that, let's wrap. If you like this continent, content, it's too early in the morning. It's December 20th. It is roughly 6:30 Central Time, 7:30 Eastern Time. I'm down here at Coleman, Alabama, well, Woodstock, Alabama, picking up a load of skids at this place I've been to a number of times. Fortunately, they do not let us sit in the truck. It's kind of cold out here, so I'm kind of, it sucks. But let's wrap. Like I said, it's December 20th, 5-4 whatever days to Christmas. I'm torn over. It's cold, but I got something to get off my mind. Let's wrap. So there's a lot of talk around town about the driver that got sentenced 110 years for that truck accident in Colorado on an I-70 about 2 years ago. Got 110 years. A lot of people feel that is unjust or unfair. I'm gonna tell you what I think. This is what I think. You don't have to agree with it. You can disagree with it. You can comment down below. Tell me how wrong I am. Tell me how right I am. I'll respond. I may respond. I may not respond. But let's rap about it. Look, I don't have no sympathy for the guy. I have no sympathy for the truck driver who literally passed up two escape ramps. Not one, not, but two escape ramps going on the way to that traffic jam. He had two missed opportunities to save four people's lives and not injure countless other people and do damage to the highway. And he just chose to pass those up for whatever reason. A lot of people say he didn't understand English. I'm sorry, that's no excuse. That is not a get out of jail free card. He knew enough English to go get a CDL. He knew enough English to pass the written test. He knew enough English to read and understand what he had to get a CDL. So there's no excuse. I'm sorry, not sorry. Look, I posted on another YouTube platform of commenting. Look, do I have sympathy for the guy? No, I have sympathy for the poor people who lost their lives. That's four people who should have been alive today had he taken the escape ramp. I feel like the sentence was fair. He took four people's lives. Why shouldn't he lose his life instead? As well, I should say. That's my personal opinion. I just can't fathom me. If I was in that situation, I put myself in that situation. I'm taking the escape ramp. And if I couldn't make the escape ramp, I'm ditching it. I'm not going to take no other people's lives. I'm going to ditch it. I'm going to give you a prime example of a time when I was a rookie driving for Pam Transport. And I was coming through, going through Nashville on my way to the split off where it goes, I think it's 65 north to Louisville, Kentucky. And this is my first time driving to Nashville by myself. It was like midday and not expecting any traffic because it's a good time to make it through the day. And I'm not expecting any traffic. So I'm moving through there. I'm going through that turn. And you got to go through an underpass to get to the split. It's like a bridge crossover. Now, I didn't know this, but now I do. But there's always traffic when it comes to that split. That's because there's always an accident in that area. Now, I was rolling through. I was doing 65. To get through that turn, I dropped it down to 55. And then, lo and behold, there is stop traffic. I am on my brakes hard. Like, and this truck is still not stopping fast enough to stop and not hit the person ahead of me. So you know what I did? I don't want to hit the truck hit the car ahead of me. I don't want to risk injuring them or killing them. So I took the shoulder, and right under that underpass is where I took the shoulder. And I was made that decision. Okay, I'm going to take the shoulder and I'm going to hit the side of this bridge. But that's better for me to hit the side of the bridge and only get in an accident by myself and live with the consequences of that than to run into the back of that person and kill or injure or possibly kill a person or multiple people. So that's what I'm saying. He broke a trucker's code. You do everything in your power to save somebody's life in that situation. A lot of truck drivers would have ditched it. Even if that means you have to go over an overpass. Some drivers have done it. I've read stories about drivers who in order to save a person's life, they risked their own. That is a trucker's code right there. He decided, nope, I ain't risking my life. I ain't risking dying for you. I'm just going to run into the back of you. And that's when he killed four people. I'm sorry, not sorry. The guy got what he deserved. As I like to say, when you play stupid games, you win stupid prizes. He played the stupid game, and he won his prize. He just didn't like the outcome of his prize. So, I personally don't care that he has spent 110 years in prison. That doesn't bring back the four people who lost their lives. Don't bring them back to their loved ones. So, no, I do not support him getting out. I do not support him getting clemency. I think it was fair and just of what he did. The time fits the crime. And he earned it. He worked hard for that prize. He worked his butt off to get that prize. So he can, to me, he can save his crocodile tears. He can save his crocodile tears. Because he's remorseful because he had to spend the rest of his life in prison. But he justified his action by saying, oh, judge, please cut me a break. If I wouldn't have did what I did, more people would have lost their lives. Okay, so he's telling the judge, look, I'd rather sacrifice four people than 50 people. It's not that bad. I only killed four people. Now, let that sit in your head. Let that sit in your head. Chew on that for a little bit. Chew on that. Because you saved four people, you saved 50 people's lives, but you killed four. Does that make it any better? Come on, let's think about that, people. So no, I will not be signing that petition. As far as I'm concerned, the guy can just rot in jail, rot in prison. Because why does he get to go live his life, continue his life? Why does he get to continue living his life and go on and move on with his life when those four people don't? I hope the governor of Colorado do not give in to mob rules and grant him clemency. I hope he sticks behind the judge. He did what he did. He took four people's lives due to his negligence. And I've read the reports. There was other drivers saying he was all over leading up to that collision. He was all over the interstate, going to multiple lanes, driving erratically, and failed to use any of the escape ramps. And before you guys jump my case, the driver should have known that he had faulty brakes. A proper pre-trip would have let him know he has faulty brakes. Before you get to that point, those hills, you got a brake checkpoint. That truck must stop to check the brakes. If you have any inkling that your brakes is not going to survive that mountain, you're supposed to stop there to check them to get them repaired or go back the opposite direction. Find a way to go back the opposite direction and it's safe. This driver failed to do any three of those things. And he definitely knew a proper preacher. And if he had faulty equipment, he knew he had faulty equipment. For real, he knew he had faulty equipment. A driver knows when he has faulty equipment. You know when your brakes, driver knows when he has brakes and when he don't have brakes. I don't care about an experience, lack of training. That's no excuse. He still should have knew that he shouldn't have been on those roads. He still should have taken an escape ramp. There is no excuse for what he did. So, yeah, to me, he can save the crocodile tears. He can save all that. And he can go kick rocks, in my opinion. But that's what I got to say about it. So this week's breakdown, I actually came out pretty far ahead. It came out ahead. Truck grossed like $4,000. And I think $29 out of what I grossed, I made $2,800. And then after taxes, it brought that down to about $2,000. And so I made out pretty good considering last week was a bunch of short runs. This week is a whole lot better. Leading up to Christmas, I think this week so far I'm at $2,000. I think after I deliver this load, I'm pretty much sure I'm going home. But I've already made my deductions and made a little bit of money. So I'm happy with that. So the week before that one, last week, it was crazy. I got a little out of control on my fueling. So that week I spent like $1,082 in fuel that week. It was out of control. I felt like it was out of control. And honestly, that week I still made the same amount of money I did this week. I think I made a little bit more this week, but my fueling was a lot better this past week. That's all I got for you guys. I wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Remember, guys out there, if you're not sure about your equipment, if you think your brakes are going bad, or you got faulty equipment, don't drive it. I, for one, in a heartbeat, will not drive faulty equipment. If it ain't working like it's supposed to, I'm getting it fixed. And if I don't get it fixed, I ain't driving it. I tell them, like, give me another truck. I ain't driving this. It's not safe. But like I said, click the like button. Comment down below. Tell me what you think. Subscribe. Like this content. I said content again. Content. And peace.